Welcome to an example in which they're asking us to find the arc sine of the sine of pi over 2. So your first thought is probably the right one, and that is what is arc sine first off? Arc sine is inverse sine. It's another way of saying inverse sine. So this is inverse sine of pi over 2. So doesn't inverse sine and sine just cancel each other out? And the answer is yes, you're totally right. And the answer to this question is indeed just pi over 2. The arc sine and the sine cancel each other out. Now, careful, they don't always cancel each other out exactly like that. They usually do. It kind of depends on the example. The way to make sure is I would go to the Desmos calculator. So here I am. Whoop, I'm not on the homepage. Here I am on the homepage of our Canvas course. Come on down to the, what did I just click the wrong button? Come on down to the course count, calculator right there. Click on that calculator. It'll open up to this Desmos calculator and then just type that in. So inverse sine, I went to function, see it's on main. I went to functions, inverse sine of pi over 2. But make sure you're in radians. See right here how it's radians and degrees, degrees, radians. Make sure you're in radian mode because pi over 2 is a radian angle. Hit enter. There it is, 1.57. Now, 1.57, if you type that in, it won't take it. Watch, if I type in 1.5, no decimals allowed. You can't put decimals. Well, then how do you know that's pi over 2? Well, here's the main way. What you can do is go to the notes. So you know on the home page, you click on notes right here, download the exam 2 notes, and then you open it up. And I'd encourage you to do that and print this out. This is the first page of the exam 2 notes, has the unit circle. Look for 1.57. There it is. See 1.57 right there, and it tells you, oh, it's pi over 2. So 1.57 is pi over 2. So you go, oh, okay. So when you get this answer in the calculator, 1.57, blah, 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 you go back to calculator and type in pi over 2, which is what we thought all along. So just like that. And of course it is, right? Because pi is about 3. So this is like half of 3, which is about 1.5. So it makes sense as pi over 2. So there we go. That's how you handle that kind of question. Let me do one more. How about cosine of arc cosine of negative 0.1? Again, you're probably thinking, well, don't they just cancel each other out? They do. Now, again, not always, but usually. So let me do it. Cosine of arc cosine of what was it, negative 0.11, I think. We'll check. Did I get that right? Yeah, negative 0.1 cosine of arc cosine. Yeah. See how the answer is just negative 0.1. And that one doesn't matter. That's not a radian or degree. That's an answer. So negative 0.1. So the answer to that, whoops, to that question is negative 0.1. So those are easy. Now, careful, they're not always going to work that way. Let me show you one that doesn't. Cosine of arc cosine one. Now, before you go 1.8, I think it's 1.8. I got it. It's 1.8. Careful, no. Let's type it in. Cosine of arc cosine of 1.8. So cosine of arc cosine of 1.8. Enter. Whoops. What did I do? I hit it. Enter. It says undefined. It doesn't say it's 1.8. It's undefined. Why? Why is it undefined? Because cosine can never be more than one. Sine and cosine, remember the graphs of sine and cosine? You know, when there's no numbers, no amplitude numbers in front, the cosine only goes up to one and down to negative one. So does the sine. So they can't be 1.8. That's actually impossible, undefined. So you don't have to memorize that though. Just type it in. You can use Desmos or your own handheld calculator during the exam. Just type it in. You'll get undefined. You go back here and go, okay. It's just undefined. Now, what do you type in? It says type in D and E if the expression is undefined. So I'm going to type in D and E. Doesn't matter, uppercase, lowercase, whatever. It'll take it. There it is, D and E. It changed it. I mean, you don't have to put uppercase though. It means does not exist. D and E stands for does not exist. So when you get the same trig function, arc sine of sine, or cosine of arc cosine, or sine of arc, oh, that's a different one. You know, when you get any of these, just type them in, see what you get. And if it comes out error or undefined, type in D and E. If it comes out the same number, then great, that's the same number. And so there we go.